It's time for Go Go Nippon, my first trip to Japan, session 5. Alright, let's get this game loaded up. See what crazy things happen in Japan that don't happen anywhere else. Why don't we stroll around the area for a little while? Sure. After that, Makoto led me around the town of Akasuza. We saw lots of temples and small amusement parks and all kinds of interesting things. Well, this is just a rough tour, but I hope you got an idea of what Asakusa is all like. Absolutely! That was really fun! Good, but if you want to know about the city of Asakusa... There! Do you see that small carriage-like vehicle over there? Yeah, it's a pretty funny-looking vehicle.
That's a jinrikisha.
It's pulled by people. It was a very popular form of transportation about 100 years ago. The word rickshaw is derived from this term, which literally means human-powered vehicle. That's pretty cool.
You can ride in it and get a very detailed explanation of the town while you travel around.
What do you think? Do you want to ride? Phrasing. There are a lot of things I want to try. Phrasing also. But I think I'll pass.
Really? We can do it if you want to.
It's fine. Your explanations were more than enough for me.
Well then, I'm glad I came along with you. Now, where should we go next?
Do you want to go somewhere to eat? I'm starving.
Oh, sure. It's about time for lunch, isn't it? But, I wonder what we should eat.
That reminds me, I noticed it when we were walking around, but Japan really has a lot of restaurants, doesn't it?
That's true, not to mention it. A lot of them are cheap chain restaurants, so you can really get by in Japan on the cheap if you go there often.
And the storefronts all have realistic wax models of the food to provide elaborate samples. That I remember from when I was a little kid. There was the special where Big Bird goes to Japan, and I remember that he couldn't read Japanese, so he was trying to order, and he was very emphatic that he wanted what was in the store window, so they gave him the wax models. The things that stay in your head. I heard Japanese people are obsessed with food, but I guess that's true.
So, is there anything you have a taste for?
Anything I have a taste for? Another choice for once. This game is game-like. I want to eat noodles.
Noodles? I know, let's go to that store.
What store? Where exactly are we going?
That's...
Soba?
That's right, eat up.
I'm looking at a very simple dish, held high with some kind of pasta. How are we supposed to eat this?
Do you see the small bowl filled with broth?
Yeah, it's almost like a little cup. Dip the noodles in it, then eat them. The key is to slurp them loudly. I know it's considered rude in other countries, but noisily slurping is the icky way to eat soba.
Icky? Stylish is the word, more or less. Maybe not. Maybe cool is the right word for it.
It's cool to slurp your pasta? Japan is a total enigma. What's in this little dish?
It's called yakumi. It's like a seasoning. You can add as much in as you want.
Wow. Well, as long as it's here, I'll put it all in.
Ah.
Here goes.
Itadakimasu.
Now slurp it nice and loud. Yeah! Slurp.
I knew it.
What is this stuff? I feel like it just blew my sinuses out.
It's wasabi.
Wasabi? Okay, hold. How does this guy... His dream is to go to Japan and he doesn't know what wasabi is.
Yes, it was in the yakumi you just added. The green paste stuff. It's called wasabi and it's even stronger than horseradish. If you put too much in, it'll really blow your sinuses out.
I see.
Ah.
Huh.
Some otsuyu splashed on your face. I'll wipe it off. Just look over here.
That's the name for the soba dipping broth made from fish stock, soy sauce, and meating.
There you go. I'll just order some more otsuyu for you.
Ah, sure. Thanks.
Makoto's so nice.
The price of soba seems to vary a lot depending on the store. I think I saw it for 350 yen in some fast food places around the station, but eating in a proper restaurant is more like 700 yen. I'm sure the difference is reflected in the flavor.
Whoa, that was a good meal.
Okay then, next up.
Hmm?
Wait, Makoto?
Hmm? What is it?
What is that?
What is what?
That thing! It's over there! That giant tower!
Oh, that's called Tokyo Sky Tree.
Tokyo Sky Tree?
Yes, it's a broadcast tower that provides digital signal for all of Tokyo.
That's a broadcast tower?
Yes, until recently Tokyo Tower played that role, but now there are so many tall buildings in Tokyo that they interfere with the broadcast waves. The Sky Tree is supposed to remedy that, though it's still under construction.
Huh? Wait a minute, that thing's not even finished yet?
That's right, when it's finished, it'll be 634 meters tall, the tallest broadcast tower in the world. As man-made structures go,
the second tallest building in the world? And it's right next to Asakusa?
It is strange, isn't it, to have such a modern structure visible amidst these traditional buildings?
No kidding. But maybe that's what makes Japan special.
The other broadcast tower, Tokyo Tower, is a popular sightseeing spot in the city. We should go there too if we have time.
Maybe so.
Well, that makes a full day of sightseeing. Makoto Misaki's Tokyo tour will now be coming to an end.
This is our last sightseeing spot?
Yes, now here's the question. What kind of place do you think this is?
What could it be? It looks like your average everyday building. Let's see, judging from the shape and size, it looks like a gymnasium?
Oh, so close. It's called the Ryogoku Gokugikan. It's the promised land of Osumo.
Sumo? You mean like sumo wrestling?
Yes, I think that's right.
Dude, that is awesome. That is one thing I would like to see in Japan. Dan and Dave got to see that, or maybe just Dan.
Sumo has a long history. Some people say it goes back at least 2,000 years.
That'd make it one of the oldest still playing sports, I think.
2,000 years?
Yes, long ago it was a ritual to honor the gods.
Wow.
Have you seen it? They clap their hands in the ring and stomp their feet. It's all ritual carried over from the ancient times.
Yeah, I've seen it on TV.
I see. I did always wonder why they moved in such a strange way. It's nice to know the reason why.
Sumo wrestlers are known as rikishi. Sumo competitions between professional rikishi is called ozumo. 6 ozumo competitions take place every year. 3 of them are held here at the Ryogoku Goku Gikan.
3? You mean half of them?
That's right. The Ozumo at the Kokugigan take place in January, May, and September, and they last for 2 weeks. If you want to come, it's best to buy tickets in advance on the internet or at a travel agency.
Too bad it's not going on while I'm here. But if I come back again, I'll make sure to check it out.
Oh, and right next to the Kokugian is the Edo Tower Museum. It teaches people about the history of Tokyo. Do you want to go in and learn a bit about how Tokyo evolved since the era of the samurai?
Sure, as long as we're here, let's do it! Wow, the Edo Tokyo Museum was really fun! With all the random facts they're giving me, I'm surprised they skipped the museum. Seeing Tokyo nowadays, it's hard to imagine it looked like that 200 years ago. I really learned a lot.
So, did I? To tell you the truth, that's the first time I've been to that museum myself.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised. There are a lot of things in New York that a lot of New Yorkers don't go to.
What? Really?
Hey, it's true, unfortunately. But this was a good opportunity to go. There's a lot of things I only had general knowledge of, so it was educational for me, too.
I see.
Yes, being with you today reminds me how much we have to learn about our own country. Thank you, Eric.
Haha, I didn't do anything, but thank you for saying so,
Hey, Makoto, look at that. Who's that walking towards us?
Oh my, it's an Osumo-san.
A sumo wrestler? That's amazing, I've never seen one up close before.
He's not just a big guy, he's got this amazing presence.
That's it, he's got presence.
He's gone.
There are a lot of sumo stables around here, so I guess it's really not uncommon to see an Osumo-san walking around.
Yeah.
They're really impressive.
Heh, that was a nice unexpected treat, but I think we better bring today's sightseeing to an end and head back home.
Sure.
With no more sightseeing to do, we headed home. It was a day of unforgettable experiences, and I thought I would be able to head home in peace, but... This is unbearable. What the hell is this? Why are there so many people in this train car?
Please try to bear it a little while longer.
Right. I wish I could, but I'm seriously gonna get squished here.
Help!
Back to Wack Arnold's.
I thought I was a goner there for a minute.
Hey, Makoto, are we in
Tokyo's famous Evening Rush? Yes.
Evening Rush. So you're saying Japanese people do this every day when coming home from work?
When work and school end, everyone goes home at about the same time. A lot of people have to ride the trains, so what can you do?
What can we do? I can't believe people are just okay with this.
That's right. To prevent certain strange crimes that happen during the rush hour, there's a system in place to allow for women-only cars.
Now that is really skirting the issue.
If a man gets on them by mistake, he'll get a lot of glares.
I see. But I guess anyone who would do that deserves whatever they get. I'd better not do it. Anyway, in the future I'll try to make sure we don't ride the trains during rush hour.
Hey, let's eat out for dinner tonight.
Eat out? You mean, like at a restaurant?
Obviously, did you think I was talking about eating bento in a park at night?
Right, but why do you want to do that?
Well, you did come all the way to Japan. You want to eat at a specialty restaurant at least once, right? Well, I really like Akira's cooking, to be honest. Huh?
I mean, it's really good.
Cut it out. Stop joking around.
Huh?
I wasn't joking around.
Aki-chan gets bashful when she's praised.
I do not. I'm not bashful. Anyway, what do you want to do? If you got a request for what to eat, you better make it quick.
A request, huh? Let me think. There are a lot of things I want to eat. Phrasing. But most of those I can get in Japanese restaurants back in my country. And when I think about it, I get the feeling that the dinner Akira makes is closer to what Japanese people actually eat every day.
That's it. That's what I want.
What is it? Did you decide what you want to eat?
Yes, I want to eat that.
What's that?
Okay, sushi you can get in America. Pizza, I mean, they're bound to make it differently there. But unless they mean okonomiyaki, let's do Japanese pizza. That might actually be okonomiyaki.
Japanese pizza?
Yeah, I heard about it. They say it looks a lot like pizza, but it's way different.
Something that looks like pizza, but isn't? What could it be?
I wonder if it could be that.
That?
Yes, we have one in our neighborhood, you know.
What? I don't know what you're talking about. You'll understand when we get there.
Is this the place?
I see. Now I understand.
Yarashai!
This is a Japanese pizza restaurant?
Yes, we call it Okonomiyaki in Japan.
Score! Haha! Way to go, Ranma one half for Japanese education.
Okonomiyaki.
The wheat flour is boiled in flour, in water, then mixed with cabbage or pork or whatever ingredients you like, and then fried on top of a high iron griddle.
Wow!
So some regions even put noodles inside. Here in Tokyo, you can get a regional variety called monja. But today we'll be eating the standard okonomiyaki.
Okay, sure.
Anyway, let's put it in our order. I think I'd like to try the special.
Special?
Yeah, it's got all kinds of toppings inside. Most restaurants have one, so if you're not sure what to get, it's the simplest thing.
I see. Then I'll have the special too.
Now we fry it up.
Huh? You mean this is self-service?
Some restaurants are. Some will fry it up for you, but some let you fry it up yourself. Personally, I think it's more fun when you fry it up yourself.
Wow. I guess this guy's never been to, like, Korean barbecue or melting pot.
Okay, here we go.
Wow. Once the wheat flour mixes with the water, you mix it with the softened ingredients and spread it out. And it spreads out in a circle on the pan.
Then one side fries up, use this utensil to flip it over. It's a hard skill to master.
Really?
I guess it does take some getting used to. I still can't get used to it, no matter how I try. Here, Aki-chan, you do mine.
Okay, what about you?
Me? I think I'd like to try it on my own.
Really? Well, then watch me first.
I guess it's time. Now slip the spatula in between the pan and the ingredients. And as hard as you can,
yeah!
See? You just flip it over.
I see.
The trick is not to hesitate. Here, try it.
Okay. Slip the spatula underneath the okonomiyaki. Then, as hard as you can.
Yeah!
Ah! Oh dear, that didn't work. It really got away from you. Don't worry about it. It just caved in a little. You just have to reshape it.
I guess it really is hard to get the hang of it. But it's definitely a lot of fun frying it for ourselves.
Do you think they're cooked through?
I think so. Now we add sauce and mayonnaise and sprinkle on the aonori and katsubushi. Aonori is dried seaweed. Katsubushi is dried shaved fish. So I guess the ushi in sushi means fish.
It really adds to the flavor.
It's a necessity for okonomiyaki.
Wow.
Yes, it's all done.
I don't know if I would want something with so much mayo, but...
Have to try it before you knock it.
This is... Yes, this is okonomiyaki, the Japanese pizza. Okay, time to eat.
Huh? Wait, you mean we're gonna eat it right off the pan?
Yes, it varies by restaurant, but generally speaking, you want to leave it on the pan so you're practically panting from the heat.
I see.
Anyway, itadakimasu! Itadakimasu! Careful not to burn yourself.
It really is hot coming right off the griddle. Duh. It's hot as hell, but...
How is it?
It's great! But the sauce smells so good caking on the pan. It's got so many toppings inside it, but they're all so skillfully prepared. It's like nothing I've ever tasted. This isn't like pizza at all.
Ooh, I'm stuffed. 1,200 yen for one okonomiyaki, huh? I wonder if it would have been cheaper if I hadn't gotten the special.
Hey, Akira, want to stop somewhere on the way home?
I don't think so. I have all my shopping done.
What about you?
Me? Not a special...
That's it. I could use some money. Is there a bank somewhere I can make a withdrawal?
A bank? Sorry, but all the banks are closed at this hour.
Really? Even the ATMs?
Most ATMs in Japan close at night, too. It may be a crime prevention measure.
I see.
Ah, but the ATMs in Konbini are open 24 hours, so you might be able to make a withdrawal if your credit card is there.
Really?
Yes, by the way, do you have any traveler's checks?
Oh, yeah. I don't have them with me, but why?
Banks are about the only place you can cash in your traveler's checks, but all the banks close by 3 p.m. So if you want to do it, make sure you do it early.
Ah, I see. Thanks, that should be okay.
Anyway, do you think we can stop by the konbini?
Of course. Is that okay, Akira?
Sure. I think he wants to do the lottery thing again? I don't know.
Thank goodness, I was able to get some cash from the konbini ATM.
They have some vending machines everywhere, but 24-hour ATMs are only in convenience stores.
And there are a lot fewer places to take credit cards than I expected. Especially in smaller restaurants, there are a lot of places you can't use them. Japan really is a mysterious country.
Or, you know, just a big city. There are lots of places in New York that don't like to take credit cards either. Day 3. Let's see what mischief he gets up to this morning.
Morning.
Oh, sorry. Morning.
Oh, good morning. You're up early.
Yeah, I got up a little earlier so I could think over where I want to go.
I see. That's nice.
Huh?
Sounds like you're getting the most out of your days here in Japan.
Yeah, of course. That's thanks to you and Akira.
When you say that, it makes it feel all worthwhile.
Hmm? Say, where is Akira?
She must still be asleep.
Oh, but if you wouldn't mind, could you try and wake her up? Here's the mischief, I guess. What? Me? Wake up Akira? But...
it's nothing to worry about. I'm not telling you to go into her room.
Just stand outside the door and call to her until you get a response. Ah, I see.
It's Akira. I have no idea what might happen to me if I go into a room while she's asleep.
Okay, I'll go wake her up.
If you would.
I wish I could just let her sleep, but we can't start the day until Akira wakes up.
Pretty sure Akira's room is the first room on the second floor.
That's it, the room with the open door. Hmm? Open door?
Wah!
Womp womp.
Huh?
Oh, this visual novel. Oh. How does this keep happening? First Makoto, now I catch Akira in a compromising situation? Just stay cool, stay cool.
Good morning. You didn't come downstairs, so she sent me to wake you up.
But I see, you're already awake, so that's good.
So anyway, I'll be waiting for you downstairs. Come down when you're ready.
Whew. Now she should know it's just a misunderstand.
Or not.
Ah, Peeping Tom, pervert.
I'm not. It's misunderstanding. Makoto just asked me to come wake you up.
Shut the hell up. You can't save yourself now.
Someone help.
I wonder if Akira's still mad at me. She's been quiet all through breakfast. Also, she looks mad. Yep, she's still totally mad.
Come on, Aki-chan, don't stay mad.
It's your fault for not waking up on time, don't you think? That was just...
and I don't see how you can blame him when you were the one changing with the door open, right?
Hmm.
Anyway, it's entirely your fault, so don't be mad at him, okay?
Fine.
Now, as a token of your store friendship, won't you make the after-meal coffee?
Yes, ma'am. Whew, that was close.
Thanks, Makoto. You don't have to thank me. I'm the one who asked you to get her.
That's true, but...
anyway, it's over now, so let's not bring it up again.
Got it. Okay, here's the coffee here.
Ah, thanks.
Well, at any rate, I'm glad we can make...
hmm? This coffee is...
what is this? It's full of salt!
Did she put salt in it instead of sugar?
I'm sure it was just innocent.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
I guess it wasn't a mistake.
Nothing at...
In that case, I'll just have to...
Oh. Huh?
Go.
Whew, that coffee sure was great. Thanks.
That was salty as hell.
Idiot.
Hmm?
Give me your cup.
Huh?
Give it to me. Come on. Come on, you do something like that. How am I supposed to stay mad at you? Akira. Okay, here's another coffee. Take it. Don't worry, there's nothing weird in it this time. What's wrong?
Nothing.
Then drink it up. It'll get the taste out of your mouth.
Yeah, thanks.
Oops.
Discovered a new feature.
Anyway, let's decide where to go today.
Alright, I no longer know where I want to go, so let's just go in order.
Ikebukuro.
I don't know where the exit marks are.
I think I'd like to go here. Ikebukuro, right? That means... Okay, I'll be showing you around. We'll head out right after I clean up breakfast. Get your things ready and I'll be right there, okay?
Got it. Ikebukuro, huh? I wonder what kind of place it is.
Well, here we are. This is today's destination.
Ikebukuro.
This is... That's right, this is Ikebukuro, the second busiest travel destination in Japan.
Second busiest? You'd think the second busiest place in Japan would rank pretty high on a world scale, too. And there really are. It's as crowded as I expected for the second busiest place in Japan. Just leaving the station and coming here, I feel like there were an awful lot of people.
I should inform you, this is even the busiest day of the week.
What? Seriously?
Yes, on Saturday and Sunday, the number of people you'd see here would put this to shame. This road, the Sunshine 60 Dori, is the most popular street in Ikebukuro.
Huh, Dori, meaning street.
This doesn't even compare to the crowds you'll see here on the weekends.
Wow, I can't believe it.
There are a lot of people here today already, if it doesn't even compare. But as scary as that prospect is, I'd kind of like to see it. The town of Ikebukuro was once a very small village. But about 100 years ago, a train station was built here. From there, the population grew rapidly until it became the city we see today.
Wow, that's amazing!
They also say a lot of the painters and artists lived around here before the Second World War. They called it Ikebukuro Montparnasse, after the Montparnasse in France.
I think I remember hearing about that in Samurai Champloo, but I'm not sure. Wow, an artist town?
Yeah, and maybe because of that, a lot of manga artists still live here today.
Manga?
I love manga, especially Japanese manga.
Really?
Have you heard of Tezuka Osomu?
Okay, if this guy doesn't know what that is, this dude is everything he says is invalid.
Tezuka? Isn't that the man they call the god of manga?
That's right, you really know your stuff.
Tezuka Osomu also lived in the Ikebukuro area. They say that many aspiring manga creators make pilgrimages to his apartment.
Wow! I always thought of manga as some kind of disposable entertainment, but when you think about the history like that, it really does feel like an art form.
It is. It's not fully appreciated the way within our country either, but... Well, anyway, now that you know a little bit about the history of Ikebukuro, let's walk around a bit, shall we?
Okay, then let's go! Or so I like to say, but... Hold on. I think I hear my daughter. Give me a second.